Justin Quinn is a championship MVP as Oral Roberts cruises to yet another Summit League title, their 21st in program history. And look, the dominance has been special throughout the year. You were on the team last year when you guys kind of struggled a little bit compared to this year in conference play. What's so different about this team compared to last year?
You know, 1 through 9, I think everyone's special.
Going back to Sunday, just for one final time, the dogpile, you guys didn't dogpile after winning the Summit League title. You did this time. Were you on the bottom of that? Where were you on that? And did anybody come out of there with any cuts or anything? I know you're wearing spikes, so.
Yeah, no, so I made sure I didn't jump on top.
Welcome to a special edition of the Summit League Spotlight here in the Midcoast Sports Studios. It is College World Series week. I'm Kienan Dixon. We brought in the heavy hitter, Darren Wallace. And this is spring has been incredible. We've witnessed a special run by Oral Roberts as they've punched their ticket to Omaha. The Golden Eagles are just the third regional four seed to reach the College World Series. Fresno State won it all in 2008. And Stony Brook made the trek from New York in 2012. Redemption in game two, and the best two words in college baseball, Game 3, with sophomore Brooks Fowler on the bump, Oral Roberts needed one win to book their ticket to Omaha. ORU scored one in the first, followed by a three spot in the bottom half by Oregon. After that, it was all ORU. The Golden Eagles plated one in the third and three in the fourth, taking the lead and holding on to it the rest of the way, cruising to an 11-6 win and moving on to the College World Series.
What is it about this team? It's almost like you guys don't know how to lose. I mean, you've been down multiple times and you've clawed your way back. It's like you're unfazed with the big lights and everything that's going on here.
Yeah, we're just full of old guys, to put it in simple terms. But we don't ride the emotional roller coaster the best we can. Don't matter if we're up 8 or down 8.
He gets the gummy worm over there at first base.
Try and get more hits so I get more 20 snakes.
I like it. I mean, you get on base, you get a present. Can't go wrong with 20 snakes.
You love seeing the guys go out there and get those when they get on base, so it's pretty cool though.
It kind of gives me a little more incentive to get a hit. I mean, those things are pretty good, so every time I go to the play, I want one, so I'm gonna try to get on base to get one.
I'm Guy Fieri, and we're rolling out.
Go Tigers! Go Tigers! Yeah, you're right.
What city is Oral Roberts University in?
Oh, Oral Roberts City? I'm gonna go with Indiana, or Illinois, or not Illinois, Chicago, I don't know.
Kind of close. I mean, in the same country.
Yeah.
All right, we're phoning a friend here. Who wants to be a millionaire or a Golden Eagle? Tony V, man.
Do you look like we worried about Tony V right now?
No, we're eating jambalaya. This is very good stuff, man. Yeah, I think there's going to be a ton of fireworks. ORU doesn't hit as many home runs as some of the other teams here in the College World Series, but they hit timely home runs. Blaze Brothers hit that ninth inning home run that brought ORU all the way back, three-run shot, gave them the lead going into the bottom half of the ninth when Kay Denton came in and shut it down. But like you mentioned, Florida, I mean, a 456-foot home run that sealed the win for them against Virginia on Friday. This is going to be a fun one, 6 o'clock on ESPN2. And it'll start with the sophomore, Brooks Fowler, who has been spectacular all season, 9-1 with a 3.27 ERA. Last time out, he went 4 2/3 in a no decision against Oregon in that decisive game 3 to send ORU to the College World Series. He'll be going against the junior, Cam Brown, from TCU out of Texas, and he's been struggling a little bit. 3-2, he's their traditional Sunday starter this year with a 5.5 ERA. Last time out was against Arkansas to send TCU to the Super Regional, which they swept Indiana State in. So last time out for him, 2 hits, 4 runs across, 4 walks and 2 home runs, and we talk about the Achilles heel for ORU. Home runs could be the Achilles heel for him today. Captain Jake McMurray grew up in Tulsa, going to Oral Roberts games as a fan, and then donned their jersey. And for the years that he was at Oral Roberts, made an impact. The first 2 seasons, they didn't make the Summit League tournament, and they were one of the first teams in program history to not do that. He turned it around, got things going in the right direction, and of course made it here in the College World Series in his final year. Now an alumni, McMurray thinks about the times that he had at Oral Roberts and everything that he's leaving behind as he moves into the next chapter of life.
For a long time, I felt like I didn't really belong here. But I sure as heck feel like I belong now. And I'm proud to say that, and I'm proud of this team for what we were able to accomplish and what we went through together.
Signing off for one final time here from the College World Series in Omaha, Nebraska, I'm Kienan Dixon for the Summit League.